Hello everyone, welcome to our English class. This is our final English class, phase 3, week 20 for 8th grade. Today we are going to have a review of the simple past. We're going to have a biography of a beloved family member. Yes, that's the final project, writing a biography for a beloved family member, okay? Nuestro proyecto final, escribir una biography of a beloved family member, de un amado miembro de nuestra familia. That's our final project, okay? For the last guide, para la última guía. For the last guideline. First, we are going to look over some parts of the guideline. Yes, first we have here a review, un repaso del simple past, de los regular verbs. Acuérdense, regular verbs, porque todos terminan en ED. Yes, aquí dice, mire. Regular verbs. They are regular because they all finish in ed or ed. Yes. Now here we have another review, otro repaso, de los irregular verbs. Okay. Another review of the irregular verbs. Otro repaso de los verbos irregulares. Acuérdense que estos no terminan en ed. No. They don't finish in ed. They change in different ways. They are written in different ways. Yes. After that, we have a little reading practice. Tenemos una práctica de reading. Vamos a tener que leer y responder here, en esta parte. No es mucho lo que vamos a responder. Es muy poco. Okay? There are short answers. After that, we are going to fill in the blanks. Rellenar los espacios. Utilizando los verbos en pasado. Yes? The regular and the irregular. Regulares e irregulares. In the past, in English. Fill in the blanks. Rellenando los espacios. Con the regular and irregular verbs in the past in English. Yes? After that, we are going to have the final project, que como ya dijimos is writing a biography of the beloved family member. Yes, writing a biography. Remember, the biography has to be in English and you have to write it in past using the verbs in the past. You have to use regular and irregular verbs in the past. Okay, this biography will be in a poster, en un cartel, yes. In a poster, in a cartel, you're going to write the biography. The biography will be in a poster. La biografía va a ser en un cartel. In English, of course. Now, let's go back to the beginning. Here we have the activation part. Okay? Esta guía tiene como objeto resumir y aplicar tus conocimientos de verbos regulares e irregulares en inglés. Regular and irregular verbs in English. In the simple past, en el pasado simple. Repasaremos las temáticas estudiadas en la unidad 6 del programa de inglés de octavo grado para lograr este objetivo. Instructions. Work on the following worksheets to review regular and irregular verbs in the simple past. Okay? So let's work in these worksheets. Okay? Trabajemos en estas páginas. If you pay attention to the pictures, las fotos nos dicen cuál es el verb. Okay? Las fotos nos dicen cuál es el verb in English. So cook, cocinar, yes. Walk, caminar. Study, estudiar, yes. The pictures tell us what is the verb in English, okay? Keep in mind that these are regular verbs. So since they are regular verbs, they all finish in ed. For example, instead of saying cook, you will say cooked, okay? Instead of saying walk, you will say walked in the past, okay? In the past. Remember, those are regular verbs in the past. They all finish in ed. They all finish in ed. For example, phone, you say phoned. Shave, shaved. Watch, watched. Wash, washed. Yes, they are regular because they all finish in ed. Now, complete this part. Okay? Watch to be all night. Aquí está respondido. Mire, watch to be all night. You have to write it in past. So, he. Y aquí falta un verbo. Yes, there's a verb missing. Dinner for the whole family. He cook. Cocinar. Yes, pero en pasado. Cooked. He cooked dinner for the whole family. Yes. Sarah to some music. To some music. Music. ¿Dónde estaría ese verbo que hace falta ahí? ¿Dónde puede estar? Here it is. Listen. Escuchar música. So, Sarah Acuérdese, en pasado añadimos ed porque verbo regular. It's a regular verb in the past, we add ed. Sarah listened to some music. Okay, another example. Mr. Penn, his teeth, sus dientes. A ver, ¿en qué picture estamos viendo los dientes? ¿En qué picture do you see the teeth? Where is the... Here! Mr. Penn, aquí estamos, mire. Mr. Penn brushed, porque estamos en pasado, yes. Mr. Penn brush. Si solo lo pone así, está incorrect. You have to write it in the past in English. Mr. Penn brushed his teeth, yes. So, complete these parts by writing the verbs in the past, okay? By writing the verbs in the past. Complete esos espacios, writing the verbs in the past. Remember, they are regular verbs, son regulares, so they all finish in ed, okay? Y terminamos esa página. Vamos a la siguiente, next page. In the next page is exactly the same but with irregular verbs. En la siguiente página es lo mismo, solo que con verbos irregulares. Yes? You have to complete these parts. Tienes que completar estas partes. Fill in the blanks, rellena los espacios with the correct verb in the past. Okay? Remember, it's an irregular verb. Number one is the example. He slept. Okay? Slept like a baby. Slept. El presente de slept es sleep. Yes? Pero como lo queremos en pasado, slept. Okay? Durmió. Slept. Now, Luke, espacio, a nice shower. Shower. Veamos dónde está la shower, la ducha. Here you have. Shower. Have a shower. Have está en present. Pero como lo queremos en pasado, lo vamos a poner had. Luke had a nice hot shower. Okay? Acuérdense que estos son irregulares, así que estos no van a terminar en ed. Remember, these are irregular verbs, so they will not finish in ed. Y teacher, ¿cómo sé cuáles son los irregulares in the past? I'm going to help you, yes? You can take a screenshot here. Toma un screenshot de esto. You can take a screenshot here. Yes? Aquí están los verbs, the irregular verbs in the past. Mira. Irregular verbs in the past. Take a screenshot. Aquí están in present. En este lado están in present and in this side they are in past. Take a screenshot. Okay? Take a screenshot of these verbs because you're going to need them to finish this exercise. Okay? Screenshot here because you're going to need these verbs to finish the exercise. El único que me faltó fue este. Mira, este lo vas a usar en la parte donde veas a Justin Bieber. Begin is in present. In past, began. Okay? Acuérdese de este. Este no se lo escribí yo. Porque lo va a ver en la parte de Justin Bieber. Begin is in present. Yes. In past begun. Okay. Now let's continue with the next part. In the next part you're going to have to read. Vas a tener que leer. Instructions. Read the four biographies. Lee las cuatro biografías. Of famous people. And match them to the pictures of A, B, C, D. Okay. Y la... juntas en el lugar correcto, donde sea A, donde sea B, donde sea C, donde sea D. For example, the letter A is John Lennon's biography. ¿Sí? Letter A is John Lennon's biography. ¿Cómo sabemos que fue de John Lennon la biography? Por lo que dice, porque nació en Liverpool, he was born in Liverpool, in England, he era parte de los Beatles, yes, his friend was Paul McCartney. So, eso nos dice, de quién es la biography. Además aquí dice John. Yes. So we know it was John Lennon. So you have to read the other biographies. Tienes que leer la biografía de los otros. Okay. For example here, Mother Teresa. Madre Teresa. Where is Mother Teresa? Si se fijan es la única mujer. ¿Y cómo se dice ella in English? She. So you have to find a biography for a woman. Yes. She was born, yes, in Albania, yes. Her real name is Agnes Gongsnya Bojaksu, yes. And she's very famous all over the world, okay. So, ya sabemos que la Mother Teresa is letter D. Entonces vamos allá arriba, let's go back. Y en la letter D, escribimos el nombre. Mother Teresa, yes. Mother Teresa, okay. The same in the others. In letter B, we are talking about Edson Dorantes. Yes, he was born in Brazil. Think about it. Who was born in Brazil? Was this one born in Brazil? Was she born in Brazil? Was he born in Brazil? No, he was born in Brazil. Pelé, yes. So, Pelé's biography is letter B. So you write Pelé, yes. You have to read the biographies. Tienes que leer las biografías, okay? Of the famous people and match them with the pictures of A, B, Z, D. A is John Lennon. D is Mother Teresa. B is Pelé. So who is letter C? Who is letter C? Correct, Steve Jobs. Okay? So read, lee, and you will know who the person is. Okay? Now let's continue. Practice. Review of the simple past tense. Repaso del pasado simple with irregular verbs. O sea que vamos a usar verbos irregulares. Complete the biography of the famous Canadian singer of Justin Bieber using the verbs in the past. Okay? Here you have the example. Justin Bieber was born. Okay? Te dan aquí el verbo en su forma presente y tú lo tienes que escribir in the past. Remember that these verbs are irregular, que son irregulares. Okay? So, aquí tenemos el verb in the present y tú lo escribes in the past. Justin Bieber was born. Y ahí está. Was born in 1994. Next. As a child, he, in the past, had. Have is in present. Have is in the past. Teacher, ¿cómo sé cuáles son los verbs in the past? Use lo que le mostré. Ahí está, ¿ven? Irregular verbs in the past. Take a screenshot of this because you are going to need it, okay? Tómale un screenshot porque lo va a usar. Take a screenshot of this because you're going to need it. Okay? Once you finish that, cuando termines esto, te vas al final project. You go to the final project. You have to write a biography. Escribe una biografía of a family member. Aquí dice, mire, choose a family member who is alive or dead. Okay? Write about the most important aspects or achievements in his or her life. Okay? You can follow the scheme below. Puedes seguir este esquema que aparece aquí abajo para escribir su family member. Yes? Second, write the biography organized in paragraph. Escribe la biografía organizada en paragraphs. Similar to the ones presented in the presentation and the practice sessions. Puede ser la biografía similar a la de Justin Bieber here. Mira, está organizada en paragraphs, en párrafos. Yes? Entonces, similar, you can do the biography in a similar way. Okay? After that, dice, finally, you are ready to present your project to your teacher. Good luck. Okay? Cuando termine de hacerla, el poster o el cartel con la biography de su family member, me lo envía in a picture to my WhatsApp. Okay? So, summary, en resumen. First, we are going to review, repasar el simple past de los verbos regulares. Yes. Acuérdese que los regular verbs, ¿en qué terminan todos? They all finish in ed. Y luego hacemos otro review, otro repaso de the regular verbs. And remember, the irregular verbs, ellos no terminan en ed todos. Yes, they don't all finish in ed. Sino que cambia la forma en que se escriben. So you have to change the way they are written. Y aquí tenemos examples of irregular verbs in the past. Estos, you're going to need them. So take a screenshot of these verbs because you're going to need these verbs to finish the practice. Okay? After that, you are going to match, read and match, leer y rellenar estos espacios, yes, con el nombre correcto, with the correct name of the person in every biography, okay? So we said that John Lennon is letter A, ¿sí? Now we read, leemos aquí para averiguar quién de estos cuatro is letter B, yes. So once you find out, you write the name over here. So this one, letter B, is Pelé, yes? Now, you have to read, so tienen que leer, letter C and letter D, yes? Y adivine, who of these four people is the person in letter C and who of these four people is letter D? And you write, y escribe aquí el name, okay? El nombre of the person who is being presented in the biography. After that, you fill in the blanks, rellena los espacios con los verbos in the past, con los verbos en el pasado, que están presentados aquí, ¿yes? Aquí se los presentan entre paréntesis in present y usted los tiene que escribir in past, ¿ok? Hay una mezcla de regulares e irregulares, ¿yes? You can use again this chart, puedo usar este cuadro, you can use again this chart, remember to take a screenshot of the chart because you're going to need to solve the exercise. And finally, you create a poster with the biography of a beloved family member, okay? Haces un cartel con la biografía de un familiar que tú quieras mucho, okay? Can be dead or alive, puede ser vivo o que haya muerto, okay? Anything you need. After you do that, you send me a picture to my WhatsApp with the finished work, okay? This is it. Eso es todo. This is the final guide. Esta fue la última guía, okay? Felicidades a todos los que llegamos hasta el final. Las clases seguirán hasta el próximo año. Bye, guys.